Hello, Patrick Walchuk here, agent in Ottawa team, doing an update on the Ottawa real estate market to the end of August 2019, and we'll be comparing that to August of last year. So August was a tremendous, tremendous month. There were 1,300 residential homes sold, and that's almost a 10% unit increase over August of last year. The average price was $485,000, which is a huge jump of almost 12% over August of last year. For condominiums, there were 431 condos sold, and that's a 9% increase over last year. And in terms of the units, and in terms of the prices, the average condo in Ottawa is now $309,000, and that's an almost 12% increase. So units are up for condos and residential, prices are up for condos and residential by a significant amount. In terms of the inventory level, what is in effect driving these prices is that the residential number of homes for sale is down 22%, and I know you're listening to a broken record. It's been the same way all year. For condominiums, the inventory levels are down 44% over last year. And just a final number I'll give you in terms of how long it's taking homes to sell in Ottawa right now. For residential properties, they're selling in 42 days compared to 58 last year. 42, 58 last year. Condominiums, it's even more dramatic. They're selling in 43 days compared to 68 days last year. And all of this put together, we're still seeing bidding wars on a daily basis with, I've been involved with places that have 16 to 18 offers on them, going for 40, 50, 60,000 over list price for a modest little townhouse. So, that's it for Ottawa stats in general. When we are looking at the area of Orleans, what's going on there for, again, August, is that there were 188 sales compared to 193 last year. So that's down modestly by about 2.5%. When we break that down into freehold versus condo, there were 138 freeholds that were sold, and that was down 2.1%. And again, Orleans is going through the same kind of lack of inventory as the rest of the city. Now, condo sales were down 4%. There were 50 of them that had sold. The average price for all types of homes in Orleans for August was $413,000, which is 15% higher than last year. So unit sales were down a little bit, and prices were up a whopping 15%. Now here's a number that kind of jumps out. The average price for a detached single-family home in Orleans is $522,000, and that's up almost 21%. In terms of how long it's taking for homes to sell, they're going in 27 days compared to 44 days last year. Those are the highlights. And you'll find much more information on our website about the particulars of homes, whether they're semi-detached or condos, apartments versus townhouses, that kind of thing. So moving on to Barrhaven, there were 118 homes sold in Barrhaven compared to 150 last year. That's a decline of 27%. Now of that, 102 of them were freehold or residential homes. That's down almost 18%. And there were 16 condominiums that were sold, and that's down 87%. Huge number. The average price for all types of housing stock in Barrhaven this year is 460, call it rounded off to 463,000, and that's up 20% over 2018. It's taking a home 19 days to sell compared to 33 last year. So it's almost been cut in half. Kanata. Moving on to Kanata. 136 homes sold versus 157 last year. That's a decline of 15%. Now, of that, 115 of those homes were freehold properties that sold. So, okay, out of the 136, 115 were freehold, and freehold sales are down about 22%. The remaining homes, the other 21, were condominiums, and those are down 16%. Now, as you might expect, just like everything else that you've been hearing, the average price is up. So unit sales were in decline, again, a lack of inventory, but the average price was up 13%. So if you're trying to find a house in Kanata right now because of the great health of the high-tech industry and the lack of inventory, you got to be prepared to get into bidding wars. And if you're a buyer out there, get yourself financially pre-qualified in writing, or you're going to have a very, very challenging time of purchasing a property. In terms of how long it's taking for a home to sell, they're selling in 23 days compared to 31 last year. So again, if you go to our website, you can get a lot more detailed information. And what you might want to consider is clicking on the link below here to subscribe to our channel, and you'll get these updates automatically. Thank you.